Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am back with another plant-based meal prep video that is so easy, and I know you guys will love all these recipes. You really seem to enjoy my last meal prep video, so if you haven't seen that, be sure to check it out in the description box or up on the screen. So this week I meal prepped 10 different recipes. They are perfect for spring, they mix and match really well, and are also kid-friendly. I love to make a list of the recipes I want to make first so I can kind of know what I need to get at the store. And then as I go, I can check the box off and you just feel really accomplished and prepared for the week. So for the first recipe, I am making some homemade nut butter. This week I splurged and got some pecans to make pecan butter. It is like frosting. It will honestly change your life. It is so good. We don't make it every week. Normally I just make peanut butter, so you can really use whatever nut that you have access to or that is cheapest for you. So I usually just roast the nuts until fragrant, put them in my Vitamix or food processor with some salt, and then blend until nice and smooth and creamy. Oh, this stuff is so good. I hope you guys try it out. As you guys saw in my last video, you know we loved a baked good. So this week I made some sheet pan pancakes. We love pancakes, but I hate standing over a hot stove, especially here in Malaysia, to make them. So I have learned how to make them in a sheet pan. You could also use a 9x13-inch baking dish. Basically, I'm just whipping up a banana pancake batter. Really simple. It's using whole wheat, whole foods, mashed banana for sweetness with a touch of maple syrup. And then I just pour this batter into a well-lined sheet pan, spread it out until smooth, and bake it at a fairly high temperature for about 15 minutes. And you will be left with the most amazing, fluffy, basically it's like cake, but healthy version. We love them. They store really well, go perfectly with some fruit, the homemade pecan butter. You guys are gonna love these. Then while my pancakes are in the oven, I like to prep some veggies to roast. I did this in the last video. I just feel like roasted veggies go so well with so many dishes. So I just cut up some carrots and cauliflower, put them on a huge sheet pan and drizzled over some olive oil, salt and pepper, and just made sure everything was really well mixed and coated in the olive oil and the seasonings. You could always obviously jazz this up with more spices, but we like to keep it simple so that it mixes and matches well with other recipes that we eat during the week. In addition to the roasted veggies, I also prepped some potatoes, some baked potatoes. I used Japanese sweet potatoes this week. I find the variety I get here in Malaysia really starchy and dense, so normally I wouldn't wrap my potatoes in foil, but these just need some extra steam and heat to cook them all the way through. So I poke holes in them, wrap them in foil, and put them in the oven with the veggies. So the last veggie dish that I prepped this week, well, that's really hard to say, veggie dish, was a simple red cabbage coleslaw. And so I just sliced up some red cabbage, about a half of a head, and shredded some carrots, put that in a bowl with some apple cider vinegar, olive oil, a little maple syrup, salt, and pepper. And as you can see, I definitely overfilled this container, but it ended up wilting down as I stirred it. And just make sure that all of the veggies are coated in the marinade and let it sit, and it just gets better the longer it sits in the fridge. Makes for a great side dish or like a zesty topping on Buddha bowls. Next, I prepped a marinade for some tofu. This is so simple. It's just lemon juice, some garlic, olive oil, soy sauce, maple syrup, or you could use coconut sugar, and pepper. And then I just sliced some firm tofu. I didn't have to press it, it's already super firm, the kind that I get here, into strips, I guess. And then I put that in the marinade and made sure to get every piece coated in the marinade before putting it in the fridge to set for about 15 minutes or however long you have. While the tofu was marinating, I whipped up a quick tahini dressing. I made a tahini dressing in my last video. This one's a little different. Both are so tasty. This one is just a simple lemon tahini dressing with tahini, lemon juice, salt, pepper, and water to thin. It lasts a long time in the fridge thanks to the lemon juice, so definitely have this on hand most weeks. Our grain for the week, in addition to store-bought bread and tortillas, was some quinoa. I just put 2 cups of rinsed quinoa and 4 cups of water into a pot, let it boil and simmer until it was cooked through, and then I let it sit off the heat for about 5 minutes before fluffing it with a fork. All the directions will be listed in the free PDF, so don't worry about remembering all of this. It's all written out for you. Next, I made some chickpea salad with 2 cans of chickpeas, some vinegar, tahini, lemon juice, salt, and I pulsed this until it was creamy and the chickpeas were broken down but not completely smooth like hummus. Then I stirred in some chopped celery, onion, and garlic, and it was this super refreshing, creamy chickpea salad, perfect for sandwiches, on crackers for a snack, stores perfectly in the fridge as well. By this time, the tofu had marinated for a little while, so I just cooked it on my wonderful griddle that my parents brought me from Ireland because it's 240 volts, but I cooked up both blocks of tofu at the same time and just cooked them on both sides until brown on about medium heat. And then I moved on to dessert. You cannot have a meal prep week without dessert, am I right? So for this simple recipe, I just melted some dark chocolate in the microwave, added some raisins until all the raisins were coated and there was just a little bit of melted chocolate left. Then I simply just took the mixture and dropped it by spoonfuls onto a parchment paper lined baking sheet. You want to make sure every raisin is touching another raisin so that when it cools, they'll stick together. This is one of my favorite desserts. You can make them as big or small as you want. Rip off little raisins. By this point, all of your food should be cooked and ready to go. Just allow it to cool before storing it in airtight containers and sticking it in the fridge. You'll have quinoa, coleslaw, some sheet pan pancakes, desserts, chickpea salad for sandwiches, marinated tofu, pecan butter, dressings, roasted veggies, sweet potatoes, to keep you nourished throughout the week. So one meal to make with all these ingredients is a Buddha bowl with the tofu, roasted veggies, quinoa, and the lemon tahini dressing. Then for breakfast, you can just put your beautiful nut butter on a sheet pan pancake, warm it up in the microwave, add some fruit, syrup, nuts, seeds, whatever you like. So delicious, so quick and easy. A lunch idea would be a chickpea salad sandwich or open-faced toast, as I like to eat it so I can eat more, with tomato and then some cabbage slaw on the side. And I just love lemon right now, so I added some lemon tahini dressing as well. For a quick and easy snack, just have some apple or banana with your nut butter. This tastes like a caramel apple with the pecan butter. It's so good. And then another dinner idea is to chop up the roasted veggies and tofu. Saute them in a little oil in a wok till they're warm. I added in some frozen peas this night just for some extra greens and protein, and then add the cooked quinoa and some soy sauce and stir all to combine to make a quinoa fried rice sort of thing. Another lunch idea is a loaded baked potato with the chickpea salad dressing, some added tomatoes, and another thing we did was chop up the tofu and roasted veggies and put them in a quesadilla. This was one of my favorite meals, so good. And lastly, you can make a wrap with the quinoa tofu, add some of that zesty coleslaw, wrap it up, dip it in the dressing, or add the dressing inside the wrap, and you've got a hearty meal. All right, guys, there's another meal prep video for you. I hope this was so helpful. Don't feel overwhelmed, just make as many of the recipes as you can and your week will go so much more smoothly. I really hope you guys check out the free PDF listed in the description box. It has all the recipes and cooking instructions and how to mix and match the ingredients to create wonderful meals. I hope you guys are staying healthy and safe wherever you are, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!